Tonight, there is a compromise following calls for this controversial statue in Haverhill to come down. The city is not going to remove it.
But they have agreed to change parts of it. WBZ's Mike LaCrosse is in Haverhill with the new plan.
Changes are coming soon to a nearly 150-year-old controversial hatchet-wielding statue in downtown Haverhill.
I think it shows respect for each other to, you know, make sure that every space is safe for everybody, both emotionally and physically.
This week, the city council voted unanimously to allow the Hannah Duston statue to remain in GAR Park, but it's recommending the word savages be erased and for her hatchet to be removed.
The hatchet in the hand is not making any points. I get that. I totally understand that, which is why I would support its removal if that's what it takes.
Hannah Duston was kidnapped by Native Americans during a raid in the 1600s. She was able to escape after killing several of her captors.
We can't just erase history. It's better to try to explain history and not repeat history, and she does serve a purpose in that regard.
The council also voted to allow for a Native American monument to be set up here in the park. The mayor has created a special commission to help with planning and designs.
And now I want to honor those who got here before the settlers did, made this land, inhabited it for thousands of years. I want to honor them in some way.
Ron Peachtree is part of the team appointed by the mayor to discuss a new monument. He's of Native American descent and hopes the commission's recommendations will help move the city forward.
The Native American belief is that you do not inherit the earth from your parents or your grandparents, that you instead hold it in trust for the generations that come after you.
In Haverhill, Mike LaCrosse, WBZ News.